Hey everybody, welcome to my fictitious laboratory, where last night, my girlfriend had a really bad nosebleed, and like any good boyfriend would do, I immediately sprang into action and grabbed some cover slips and microscope slides to collect a specimen. And after being talked to about that, we took a look at her blood. So, let's get started.
These red blood cells are unique, as they actually possess no nucleus. In high school biology, you were always taught the difference between eukaryotes and prokaryotes as having a nucleus or not having a nucleus respectively, and also that human cells are eukaryotic. However, human red blood cells are eukaryotic cells without nuclei. This video will show mostly red blood cells, with a few hidden types of cells throughout it. And at the end, I will do a little experiment with hydrogen peroxide in blood. If you enjoy these types of videos, I would appreciate a subscribe and leave a comment down below of what you want to see next. These images were obtained by performing a blood smear. Some medical professionals would look at similar images through their microscopes to diagnose some different forms of diseases, such as sickle cell anemia, which this sample shows negative. Sickle cell anemia would have curved blood cells rather than the round plump cells shown here. These stacks of red blood cells seen here are in a rouleax formation and are not usually a sign of anything good. The presence of these formations can indicate chronic diseases or acute illnesses such as infections. We'll be consulting a doctor for further investigation on this matter. Capillaries are the smallest blood vessel in your body, and a bruise is caused by busted capillary beds. However, these capillaries get so small that only one of these red blood cells that you see here can pass at a time. Here you can see one of the different cells I mentioned earlier. A later video will be made of other types of blood cells, but until then, do you have any guesses on what this is? Here you can see what happens when I put a drop of hydrogen peroxide onto the blood smear. The bubbles that you see appear are caused by the reaction between hydrogen peroxide and these blood cells, or more specifically, the hydrogen peroxide and an enzyme called catalase in the blood cells. This reaction converts hydrogen peroxide into water and oxygen. However, we'll destroy these blood cells. You may notice the cells acting erratically, and the gas bubbles getting larger due to excess gas being created. Here are the bubbles formed between hydrogen peroxide and blood. While it looks odd to the human eye when we put it on cuts, it is microscopically beautiful.